So, we will learn about what is a liter and why do we need to use liter. Children, do you remember the long line outside Golu's dairy? Golu was very easily selling milk to all the people using his glass up till now. But suddenly, his glass broke yesterday and he had to buy a new glass. Today also, there is a long queue like usual outside Golu's dairy. Like every day, Golu dipped his glass in his big tub and filled it and started filling Sher Khan's bottle. But there was a problem. Sher Khan's bottle needed 3 glasses of milk every day. But today it took 4 glasses of milk to fill his bottle. When Golu asked for money for 4 glasses of milk from Sher Khan, Sher Khan was shocked. Golu also was not sure why this happened. He got thinking that Sher Khan's bottle is the same. Then how can the capacity of his bottle change? Children, do you know why this happened? This happened because Golu's new glass is smaller than his old one. That's why earlier only 3 glasses of milk were needed to fill Sher Khan's bottle. But today with Golu's new glass, his bottle was filled with 4 glasses. Now Golu started wondering if there is a way that he can charge people for the same amount of milk every time. That's when Sher Khan suggested, "Why don't you sell milk in liters using this kind of measuring scale?" Golu did not know anything about liter. Children, do you know what is a liter? Just as we saw earlier, both the times Golu used a glass to measure the capacity of other utensils. Glass or any utensils may be of one kind, but due to different shapes and measurements, we cannot use them to measure the capacity of other utensils. To solve this problem, we use a unit called liter. We write this as L. A liter is a unit that is always the same. So, we can measure the capacity of the utensils with the help of liter. We represent it with a sign L. When Sher Khan explained this to Golu, he immediately brought a liter
measuring scale
like this one from the market. Now, Golu started selling milk using this measuring scale and took money from everybody according to the amount of milk per liter. Golu sold milk to all the villagers and everyone happily went back to their respective homes. Children, in this video, we learned what is a liter and why we use liter as a unit. In the next video, we will learn more about how we can use the liter to measure the capacity of the pot using some interesting examples. In the last video, we learned about what is a liter, which we write as L, and learned about why we should use liter. In this video, we will learn about how we can measure the capacity of any utensil using liter as a unit of measure. Today, Bhola has come to buy milk from Golu shop. Golu measured 1 liter of milk with his measuring jug and gave it to him. Bhola knows nothing about a liter. He asked Golu,
"Why are you using this new jug? And what is this liter?"
Golu explained to Bhola about the liter. Bhola became very excited about the liter. He immediately said to Golu,
"You have this 1 liter scale for measurement of milk. But how can I measure the capacity of my household utensils in liters? Please explain this to me."
Golu went inside his dairy and came out carrying a 1 liter bottle like this one. He measured the milk using his 1 liter jug
and poured it into the 1 liter bottle
and showed Bhola that the bottle was completely filled with his 1 liter jug. So the capacity of this bottle is also 1 liter, and Bhola can use it to measure the capacity of any vessel. Bhola thanked Golu and happily went to his house with that 1 liter bottle. Bhola got excited and collected some of his utensils. He first filled Golu's 1 liter bottle with water fully. Now, Bhola filled the water in his bowl with that 1 liter bottle.
But what is this?
Bhola's bowl is full.
But there is still a lot of water left in that 1 liter bottle. Children, can you tell me what this means? Exactly! This means that Bhola's bowl capacity is less than 1 liter. Now Bhola once again filled that 1 liter bottle with water, and this time he tried to fill his pot with that 1 liter bottle. But this time the 1 liter bottle was empty. but the pot also remained quite empty. Children, what does this mean? Yes, this means that Bhola's pot has a capacity of more than 1 liter. Children,
here are some utensils Bhola collected.
Can you guess
which of these utensils have capacity less than 1 liter and which have capacity more than 1 liter?
If you want, you can stop the video and try to find the answer. Well done, children. You have found the right answer to this. The capacity of these utensils is less than 1 liter, and the capacity of these utensils is more than 1 liter. Bhola was very happy to learn about the liter and decided to tell his friend Babban about it too. Children,
we learned how to use liter to measure the capacity of utensils.
In the next video, we will look at some of the misconceptions related to liter. In the previous video, we learned about how we can use liter L to measure the capacity of utensils. In this video, we will see some misconceptions related to this. Bhola is so excited about his 1 liter bottle that he has come to Babban's stall today to share about his experience. Bhola told Babban everything about measuring the capacity of utensils in liters and also said about how Golu gave him that 1 liter bottle.
Babban asked Bhola if he can see his bottle.
Oh no! What happened? The bottle slipped from Bhola's hand and fell on the ground and broke.
Both Bhola and Babban were very sad. Babban asked Bhola if they should both go to Golu and take 1 liters of bottle for themselves. Bhola and Babban reached Golu's dairy. Bhola told Golu the full story of how the bottle broke, so he needs a 1 liter bottle for himself. But Golu only had one such bottle. He gave that to Babban and gave Bhola a jug. Bhola immediately said to Golu,
"What is this, Golu? You gave me this jug instead of a 1 liter bottle. We can only measure using a 1 liter bottle, right?"
Children, do you think Bhola's statement is true? Golu laughed. He took the jug from Bhola and poured milk from 1 liter measure into the jug. The jug was completely filled with milk. Golu explained to Bhola.
Look, Bhola, if this jug was completely filled with 1 liter of milk, what does it mean?
Bhola immediately replied,
this means the capacity of this jug is 1 liter.
Bhola now understood Golu. Children, remember that it is not necessary that only a 1 liter bottle has the capacity of 1 liter. Capacities of different types and sizes of utensils can also be the same. Just like we saw here that the capacity of both the bottle and jug is 1 liter. Come, let's try it out using more utensils. If we fill this pot with water from this 1 liter bottle, we will find that the pot is completely filled with this 1 liter bottle and the bottle is also empty.
In this way, how much is the capacity of this pot?
That's correct. 1 liter. Now, can we fill this pot of water? Let's find out. Oh, wow! The pot has completely filled with 1 liter of water. This means the capacity of this water pot is also 1 liter. Children, you have seen how even though these utensils are different and their shapes also different, their capacity is the same as 1 liter. Bhola and Babban said thank you to Golu and happily returned to their homes, taking their bottle and jug. Children, in this video, we saw some misconceptions
related to using
the liter to measure the capacity of different vessels.
Children, in this video,